I blew that one.
Oh, Karen, relax. The pop quiz caught everyone by surprise. By the way you study, if anyone aced it, you did.
I don't think so. My shift at Kelly's last night and my English assignment, and I hardly even had time to finish my stupid history.
Yeah, well, there's always some serious pressure right before Christmas vacation. All we have to do is survive the next 10 days, and we got plenty of time for some serious partying.
Yeah. Well, it'll give me a good chance to get in some overtime at Kelly's.
Wait, no, you don't have to work over Christmas vacation, do you?
Well,
you see, a bunch of us were going skiing like we do every year, and I was just hoping you'd come with me.
No, I don't think so. I don't ski.
I'll teach you. It's just balance, like riding a bike.
Well, you make it sound easy.
Karen, we would have such a great time.
I'm sure we would. My nose gets cold and it runs, and I'm in the snow.
Well, but it's more than just being in the snow. It's the après-ski scene. It's you and me, bundled up in blankets in front of a cozy fire. The snow falling outside. It's romantic.
Yeah, that sounds great.
Trust me. It'll be 2 weeks you'd never forget.
Well, also, I don't know, because I have, you know, Ruby's depending on me, and I don't know if I could get that much time off work.
Jagger could cover for you.
Yeah, I guess I could ask him.
Don't guess. Promise me.
Okay, I promise. Hey.
Hey. Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. Scholar's a rock, aren't you?
Maybe. It's the wrong way to go to chemistry class, you know.
Oh, I'm not going to chemistry. I'm going to the nurse's office.
No, you don't look sick to me.
Well, thank you. Let's just say that a couple of aspirin and a nice, quiet little nap sounds much better than an exam.
You know, Mr. Tom is going to spring a test today.
I know.
And, I feel kind of weird all day, kind of lousy, you know?
Yeah, you look
I might even have a fever coming.
I think you...
Yeah,
oh, yeah, you have a fever, honey.
Yeah.
Maybe you should go to the nurse's office with me. We can make each other feel better.
Yeah, why don't we do that?
Okay.
Have you back in your afternoon classes with no problem at all. Did I say something to amuse you, Johnny?
Oh, no, ma'am. I was thinking how glad, I mean, the school is to have a nurse like you. I mean...
Why, thank you. It's nice to know my efforts are appreciated. I don't see how any learning can take place if the students don't feel well.
Yeah. In school, you know.
Absolutely. That's what these little viruses do.
Yeah.
Untreated, things can spread so quickly. I'd have half the school in here. Warm.
Yeah. I feel very hot.
Well, all right, you just stay here a while.
I wouldn't want Mr. Thomas to think I was goal-breaking or something.
Your health is far more important than chemistry class. Now, I've got to go down to the gym to patch up a couple of boys on the football team. No socializing, Johnny.
Of course not, ma'am.
I wonder if something's going around.
You know, I would hate to think if someone in the school would get really sick one day. You know, what would happen?
She put the thermometer in my mouth. And then she left the room. So I put it under the hot water. Voila, instant temperature.
I just rubbed the thermometer against my jeans. The friction heats it right up.
Really?
Really.
Well, rubbing against these jeans, I could see how that could make anything, or anyone, hot.
Who?
Me.
I don't think that's what the nurse had in mind, you know.
Wow. You heard what the nurse said. I mean, she said that we can't really be expected to learn anything, right? When we're not feeling good.
Oh, she said that, didn't she?
Uh-huh. So let's make each other feel good. Johnny.
Is this, doctor's orders?
Brenda's orders.
When she comes back, she won't be alone, all right? We have to get out of here.
I know.
They both came in here with flu symptoms. Mr. Gordon, I'm so glad you're here. I had the most horrible headache this morning when I came in here. It was excruciatingly painful.
Yeah, maybe I should think about medical school, you know.
My office, now!